Hey guys, Doctor Prasoon here. Today, the 28th of January 2020, as I film this video, the death toll due to coronavirus infection has crossed 81 across the world, and more than 3,000 persons have been confirmed with the novel coronavirus infection, or popularly known as the China coronavirus. So you being a person in India, should you be worried? And why are cases not being reported in India? That's coming up in this video. This is Do4D, an online doctor consultation platform. So let's get started. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and when you do that, please click on the bell button so that you get notified when we release newer videos. Before finding out whether you should be worried about the coronavirus infection, you should first know a few things about the coronavirus. It is called a coronavirus because of its shape. It is a crown-shaped virus, as you can see in this picture. You know all the story behind the coronavirus infection. The SARS, which took many lives back in 2003, and the MERS, which is the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, which again took thousands of lives back in 2012. All these were variants of coronaviruses. This time also, it is a newer variant of the coronavirus, a genetically mutated one, which has been found capable to spread from one person to another. It started back in December in a tourist city in China, Wuhan, and now it has spread to more than 14 countries, including United States, Canada, Australia, France, Nepal, and many Asian countries, but not India as of now. So what are the symptoms when a person gets infected with the novel coronavirus? Usually the person will be asymptomatic, or he will develop only mild symptoms, mild upper respiratory tract infections, which include a common cold, a sore throat, cough, and a fever. It usually subsides all by itself. But in some persons, this same virus can lead to lower respiratory tract infections, causing pneumonia-like condition, and that is the most common cause of death. When a person is affected with lower respiratory tract infection due to novel coronavirus, he might develop chest pain, breathing difficulty, very high-grade fever, malaise, fatigue, tiredness, headache, intractable cough, and yes, in these persons also, it usually starts as a mild infection. It is very difficult to differentiate between a viral infection, a flu, and this new China coronavirus infection. It can only be confirmed using laboratory tests. When talking about any infection, you should clearly understand the concept of incubation period. Incubation period is that time period between the actual exposure to the pathogenic organism and the onset of symptoms in an infected person. In the case of China coronavirus, the incubation period is said to be 14 days. In the last 2 days, you might have read about the Chinese health ministry saying that the China coronavirus can be infective even in the incubation period. Now, what does that mean? It means that a person can transmit the infection to a healthy person even before developing any symptoms of the infection. There is no need to be worried about this new information, because as I already said, when a person becomes infected, he will automatically become symptomatic. There will be cough, sneezing, and other respiratory tract symptoms. Without the person coughing and sneezing, the chances of this virus to spread from one person to another is highly unlikely. But another way to interpret the 14 days incubation period is the safety. If you have recently traveled to China, and if you have not developed any symptoms within the next 14 days, then it can be safely assumed that you are not carrying the virus. You are actually safe from the virus infection. So how does the coronavirus infection spread from one person to another? It is through the droplets that we cannot see. When an infected person coughs or sneezes, millions of these droplets are passed on into the air surrounding that person. And when we inhale such droplets, that person can become infected. Infection can also spread through contaminated hands. When you touch on a surface or anything which is contaminated with the virus, it could be a clothing used by an infected person. It could be any inanimate object used by an infected person. When you touch on such objects, your hands, your fingers gets loaded with those viruses. And as we all know, these viruses enters our body through the orifices or the openings. It could be our mouth, it could be your nose, or it could be even your eyes. So when you unknowingly touch your eyes, rub your eyes, or bite your fingernails, you are ingesting that virus. That's how the virus enters your body. So that is why all doctors, all the healthcare professionals repeatedly ask you to wash your hands thoroughly with soap and water to prevent any type of infection. You can easily get an infection if you stand within 1 meter of a person who is coughing or sneezing. Stay away from persons who are sick. Avoid close contact with infected or sick persons, particularly with those persons who have returned from China and other affected areas. Now, coming back to our original question, if you are a person living in India, should you be worried? The answer is yes and no. You should be worried if you have recently traveled to China and other affected areas. You can see a map of the affected areas here. If you have traveled to these areas within the last 10 days, you should be worried. You should be more worried if you have developed any symptoms like fever, cough, cold, or other respiratory symptoms after returning from such a travel. You should also be worried if your age is above 60 years, if you are already suffering from conditions like diabetes, high blood pressure, heart diseases, kidney diseases, or if you are taking immunocompromising drugs such as steroids, if you have recently undergone bone marrow transplantation, if you have undergone dialysis. All those conditions which compromise your immunity will make you more prone to catching this infection. China coronavirus has now been confirmed in almost 14 countries, 5 cases in the United States as of now, and other countries including Canada, Australia, France, Nepal, South and North Korea, Japan, Thailand. In all these countries, it has been found that the persons who have been confirmed were mostly suffering from upper respiratory tract infections. And that is actually a good thing. For the upper respiratory tract infection to spread from one person to another, it is very difficult for the virus to actually make it possible. On the other hand, the 3,000 confirmed cases in China, most of them are suffering from lower respiratory tract infection. That means it can easily spread from one person to another through droplets, because when that person coughs up or sneezes, if it is a lower respiratory tract infection, the chances of the virus spreading from one person to another is very high. Another thing to note here is that in India, most of the cases are underreported. There is lack of resources to test and confirm the diagnosis of coronavirus. Many persons have been isolated, many persons are under strict surveillance, and all the major airports in India have a screening program in place to identify the persons who are landing in our country with the symptoms of a coronavirus infection. But what about those persons who are landing in India within the incubation period? What about those persons who have landed in India in those minor airports? In order to confirm a China coronavirus infection, laboratory test needs to be done. And that single test can take lots of time and money. If one such case is reported in India, it requires lot of work, lot of money, lot of personnel to be engaged to contain that infection. Work has to be done to contain the infection. Public health awareness has to be done. Many isolation wards needs to be created. And this is huge work, both from the side of government and from the side of private corporate hospitals. And there is a chance that someone in India is already suffering from coronavirus infection, and that case has not yet been reported, simply because that it has not been confirmed. Or that person could still be living in his house without knowing that he is actually carrying the new China coronavirus inside him. So that is a possibility. And finally, coming to how can you prevent a virus infection, if you are suspecting it, or if you are suspecting it in a person in your friend circle or in your family who has recently traveled to China or any other affected areas, just practice this one habit of washing your hands with soap and water if you are suspecting any kind of virus infection, let it be a coronavirus infection, a swine flu, or any other virus infection, if you just practice this one habit, you can actually prevent spreading the infection from yourself to another person, and you can also prevent yourself from catching that infection from an infected person. If you have a cough or cold, make sure that your respiratory secretions, the droplets that you are excreting, does not spread into the air. And for that, you should actually cover your mouth and nose when you're coughing and sneezing. You can cover your face with a towel or a handkerchief, or you can actually use your flexed elbow just like this. And when you reach home, make sure that you're washing that towel, washing your hands, washing that elbow area with soap and water. If there is any person in your family who is sick, it could be a viral infection. All the persons in that house should be washing their hands with soap and water very frequently. Salt water gargling is also good. Drink plenty of fluids, drink plenty of water, take adequate bed rest, sleep more so that your immune system is boosted just enough to kick the virus out of your body. Avoid close contact with any persons who are sick. And if you're taking care of a person who is suspected to have the infection, please practice the hand hygiene measures and the respiratory hygiene measures by covering your face. Use a mask or cover your face with towel when you're going into public places which are crowded. And always carry a hand sanitizer and alcohol cleansing hand rub with you, which you can use to rub your hands if you cannot find a source of water to wash your hands. You can find a link to such a hand sanitizer in the description box below. Now, these were the measures to prevent a virus infection or any other infection for that matter. Did you know that in India, thousands of people are dying due to H1N1 infection or the swine flu infection, which is also a virus infection? And we should be more worried about containing and preventing the transmission of such infections while being vigilant about the China coronavirus. So that's it for this video. I know you will have many questions to ask me. You can ask the questions in the comment section below. If you want to chat with a doctor directly, kindly download the DoFoodie app from the Google Play Store. I will see you in the next video. This is me, Dr. Prasoon, signing off. Take care, stay healthy, and thank you so much for watching.